Bakovic coming in quick, makes the incredible diving catch. My goodness, Bakovic.
Germani trying to get there, goes back, and did he make another one? Holy guacamole, what a catch there.
Get to the basket, passes it to Cortes, Cortes up, and one. That is exactly what I'm talking about.
Welcome to another edition of the Roadrunner Review, the 30-minute magazine show that features MSU Denver sports and their highlights from the past month. I'm Sean Tafoya, and joining me over the microphone is Celeste Zubia. Celeste, we've got so much good stuff that we're going to nix the anchors and give the people what they really want, and that's more highlights for the audience.
Really, Sean? I thought it was because Eric was out of town and didn't have time to film something in studio.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. The first lesson of broadcasting on the Roadrunner Review, you don't badmouth the boss, or you may not be on the show next month.
Good point, Sean. Sorry about that, Eric. You know we love you.
So with that, what's coming up on the show, Celeste?
Well, Sean, it's playoff time for our men's and women's soccer teams, so hardware is on the line. Men's and women's basketball is tipping off their 2016-2017 seasons, so plenty of hoop highlights, and we tell you the tale of Enrique Cortes from men's basketball and how he made it all the way over from Spain to right here in the United States.
And don't forget, Celeste, we'll have the top plays from the past month, and you can bet it will get the Twitter world trending in no time. But before we get to some playoff highlights from the volleyball world, let's hand the mic to Juan Arellano, who has all the Roadrunners news. What's up, Juan?
Sean, I still can't believe that Celeste would badmouth the boss. Eric, you're doing a fantastic job. Thank you for all that you do.
Whatever, you brown noser.
Anyway, let's get the beautiful audience up to date on some Roadrunner news. First, let's bring you some cross-country news. The teams hosted the South Central Regionals at Washington Park. The men's team finished 12th overall and were led by junior Brandon Croggy, who crossed the line in a time of 33 minutes and 26 seconds, finishing in the 51st place. The women placed 15th overall and were paced by junior Erika Ruiz, who finished 31st place in a time of 23 minutes and 23 seconds. That concludes the cross-country season, as the indoor track and field season will get going here in December. The Regency Athletic Complex continues to bring in awards, and this time it comes from the Mayor's Office, winning the Sustainable Style Award from the 2016 Mayor Design Award Ceremony. The complex not only provides a home for our soccer teams, our softball and baseball teams as well, as our tennis teams, but it also serves as a place for the surrounding community to come in and learn the great lessons in life using sports. Well, that's all I have. Back to Sean and Celeste for some volleyball postseason action.
Thanks, Juan, and let's get into that incredible volleyball team who finished the Rocky Mountain Athletic Conference with a perfect 18-0 record, earning the number one seed in the conference tournament.
That top spot gives head coach Jenny Glenn and her squad the right to host first round action at the Auraria Event Center. But before we get into the tournament, let's tell you who won some regular season awards from the RMAC. What a year it has been for MSU Denver Volleyball. After the team went undefeated in conference play, it is no surprise that senior Brandy Tor was not only named Setter of the Year in the RMAC, but also Player of the Year. And first-year head coach Jenny Glenn was named Coach of the Year. And along with Brandy Tor, Michaela Smith and Ryan Herdeman got first-team all-conference, Stephanie Laraway with second-team, and last but not least, Alyssa Kelling got honorable mention. They definitely helped pave the way for their squad to become regular season champs.
The Red and Blue kicked off the postseason at home against the Thunderwolves of CSU Pueblo. We get it rolling here in the first set. Tor sets up Laraway, who puts a sweet swing on it for the point. Laraway would end up with 11 on the night. Set point now, and it's the setter Tor once again for Herdeman, who booms it. And the dig attempt is over, but out of bounds. Roadrunners take set one. CSU Pueblo pushing back now, but scope out the defense. Jackie Lopez with a diving dig. The dig on the other end and the chance for CSU Pueblo, but blocked at the net. 25-23, set two for the home side. Late in set three, it's Herdeman who goes for the slam, but no, a finesse move, and she secures the kill for her squad. Tor to Laraway again, and she puts it home. 11th kill there and the match winner.
MSU Denver took on Regis in the semifinals of the RMAC tournament, facing them for the third time this season. And boy, oh boy, was this a match for the books. To start off, Regis gets a jump on the undefeated Roadrunners early in the game. Diamond Pierce gets the kill point, and the Rangers will take the first set 25-23. The Roadrunners begin the second set on fire as sophomore Santasia Sturgis comes out of the gates and gets some kills for her team. She will go on to finish the game with a career high of 20 kills and 10 digs. A kill by Michaela Smith and a block is what this team will need to take the second set. There is just no stopping Regis defensively and offensively, and after the third set, they lead 2-1. The offense continues to roll in the fourth set, and the tables have turned for MSU Denver's offense. We are all tied up at 2-2, ladies and gentlemen. Fifth set, and then Smith with her second service ace of the game. She finished with 16 kills and 8 digs on the night. MSU Denver wins and advances to the RMAC Championship.
RMAC final time now. The Roadrunners look to finish off a perfect RMAC season, but Colorado School of Mines standing in the way. Kicking it off are the Ore Diggers as Ellie Monarch with the slam. Mines right back at it now, and Janice Jin to the back left corner and hits her spot. But anything Janice Jin can do, LaRose Curry can do better. Back left corner again, perfect spot and no hope for the defense. Mines is up 2-0. Roadrunners fight back though. Herdeman here saying, let me have a crack at it. She finds that corner as well. Roadrunners go on to take set 3. Set 4 now and match point here. Michaela Smith goes up for it and she's blocked at the net, and Mines defends their RMAC tournament title.
MSU Denver qualified for the NCAA tournament for the 17th straight season, but this time without former head coach Debbie Hendricks. They received the second seed in the South Central region for the tournament that will be held in San Angelo, Texas. They will play Colorado Mesa, who is given the seventh seed. You can catch all this volleyball action at NCAA.com.
So we wish Coach Glenn and her team the best of luck in Angelo, and we hope they can bring home a national championship. And if they do, we'll bring you all the highlights from the NCAA tournament on our next show. And we're just getting started here on this episode of the Roadrunner Review. It is playoff time for both men's and women's soccer teams, and both needed to win that RMAC championship to grab an NCAA tournament bid.
There's nothing more exciting than win or go home soccer, Sean, but the RMAC handed out some regular season awards before the first kickoff in those playoffs.
You're absolutely right, Celeste, and let's kick it off with those men's soccer awards as Josh Belfridge was selected to the All-South Central Region team. Six Roadrunners earn all RMAC team selections. Josh Belfridge and Dustin Berg were named first team All-RMAC, while Jeff Gillis, Arturo Vega, and Tyler Trujillo got the second team nod, and Dimitri Ney earned himself an honorable mention.
MSU Denver is looking to get past the first round of the RMAC tournament for the first time in 3 years as they traveled up to Golden to take on Colorado School of Mines. Both teams start off attacking, but just can't seem to find the back of the net. But Hayden Russ does his job, and he does it well, letting no balls get by him. A red card is then given out, and Mines will lose a player for the rest of the game. It doesn't seem to have an effect on the team too much, as John Hayes scores the first goal of the game, making it 1-0 in the 43rd minute. But no need to fear, because Jeff Gillis is here. Gillis gets the ball from Lolo Escobar, dribbles up, and ties the game 1-1. And overtime, here we come. About 1 minute into overtime, Josh Belfridge nutmegs the defender, and Gillis scores once again. He will advance his team to the semifinal round of the RMAC tournament after defeating Mines 2-1.
It's a good feeling. It's a good feeling to move on. Mines is always a solid game. It was tight earlier in the season. It was a tight today. Always elimination games. So fun to play. I felt like we were a little nervous in the first half, you know, even before the card. We were playing too cautious, weren't as eager and relaxed or free-flowing about the game as I wanted us to be. And so that's what we asked of ourselves the second half was, hey, you just got to be more relaxed and be more brave about the game. And they did. They responded well, and you know, a little disappointing that it took us to overtime, but, you know, a minute 11 into overtime, that's not much, I guess.
To be honest, I didn't know what to think at first. I was just in shock, but, you know, we've worked really hard this season. And to be honest, I think we earned it. You know, we came in knowing what we needed to do. You know, we know we had to get the job done. We worked really hard this week in training, and, you know, we executed, and that's what happened, and we got the win. Yeah, I mean, it means the world to me. Just been thinking a lot lately that this could be my last game. It's tournament season, so I wasn't going to go down easy this year. The last 3 years, we hadn't made it past the first round, so I was really determined this year to make my last season something special.
Coach Tittle and his squad would head on over to Grand Junction to take on Colorado Mesa, and they had themselves a hard-fought battle. MSU Denver would strike first after a goal from Jeff Gillis, but Mesa would tie it up after a goal from Luis Schrade. The teams battled for 110 minutes before Mesa advanced on PKs 4-1, ending the red and blue season. Jeff Gillis would be named the all-tournament team.
Tough loss for our men's soccer team. Let's see how the women's team did in the tournament. But first, let's get to some awards. Elise Bernard was selected to the first team All-RMAC this season, as well as sophomore Reyna Banks. And as for honorable mention, Erica Torres, Lexi Marr, Ashley Smith, and Griselda Gomez were all named honorable mention for this season. MSU Denver women's soccer team took on Colorado Mesa in the first round of the RMAC tournament. The first half was back and forth between the two teams. The half was scoreless, with each side getting 3 shots on net. Senior Lexi Marr had a great corner kick chance in the 53rd minute, and she missed the opportunity to score. And neither teams were able to finish, ending regulation 0-0. But Lexi Marr, with a little redemption, scored the game-winning goal in overtime off a corner kick deflection. The game winner was her second goal of the season. Roadrunners advance to the second round of the RMAC tournament.
The Lady Runners taking on Mines and Golden barely started in this one in the second minute, and it's Jocelyn Knott who handles the centering pass, and it's 1-0 Mines for the early lead. Later in the half, through ball put in for Knott again, but this time it's Lexi Marr getting a foot on the shot attempt for a great defensive effort. Late in half number one, and the runners finding their legs, Reyna Banks walking around a defender and in, and gets a shot off, but a diving save steers it away. Second half, and the Roadrunners looking for the equalizer. It's Nana Gomez, but her long range shot is handled. Last opportunity for the red and blue, and Bernard sends in a corner. It's headed out, but it finds Fisher, who tries Bernard again, but the pass is cleared away. Roadrunners fall 1-0, ending their season. So another successful season for both of those soccer teams, and both look to be loaded for next season as well. If you're waiting for some hoops highlights, then come on back. We have some dynamic dunks and some thrilling three-pointers from our men's team. So come on back to the Roadrunner Review.
The Rocky Mountain Athletic Conference is committed to sportsmanship.
We take pride in the conduct of our student athletes and coaches,
and ask that everyone, coaches, athletes, and spectators, treat opponents and officials with respect.
We encourage you to cheer for your favorite team.
Unruly, threatening, or obscene behavior will not be condoned.
Thank you for your cooperation and support.
I pledge.
I pledge.
I pledge.
To identify situations in which sexual assault may occur.
To recognize that non-consensual sex is sexual assault.
I pledge.
I pledge.
To create an environment in which sexual assault is unacceptable and survivors are supported.
To intervene in situations where consent has not or cannot be given.
We knew you'd be back to catch some men's basketball action, and head coach Derek Clark and his men have already jumped out to a 2-1 record to start the 2016-2017 campaign.
After grabbing a couple of wins in the D2 Tip-Off Classic in California, it was back to the Mile High City to take on the 6th-ranked team in the nation in Northwest Missouri State. MSU Denver men's basketball team hosted Northwest Missouri State in their home opener. The game starts out fast with lots of back-and-forth action between the two teams. The Bearcats' best player, Justin Pitts, knocks down a three to keep things rolling. But the action between the two teams stays the same until Cameron Williams gets the steal and makes the layup to give his team some more momentum. Metro leads by one at the half, 32-31. The Bearcats come out with some new enthusiasm and race out by 10 coming out of the half. But Roadrunners rally back. First the three-point basket by Peter Moeller, and then Sunday Detch with the and one. The game stays intense as both teams find ways to produce points and keep the game close in the last 2 minutes. Cam Williams goes up for the layup, and he is fouled. He He then goes to the free throw line with 4 seconds left in the game. MSU Denver's only trailing by one. He misses the first one and then misses the second one. MSU Denver loses their home opener 66-64.
Keep it rolling here. Davis and Elkins in town, and the Roadrunners starting with a bang. Check out Andre Harris here, the big man slicing through the teeth of the defense and a slam a jam to cap it off. For Elkins now, Edmund Parker doing work on the glass. He misses his lay-in, but gets it to fall on the second chance. He would finish with 19. Alec Williams with the drive, and he kicks it out to Sunday Detch from behind the arc, bangs it in the second half now, and it's all Roadrunners. Alex Williams' shot can't go, but going up for the putback is Cameron Williams. Let's check out more from Cameron Williams. A little shimmy sidestep up top, and he shoots through the lane and goes off the glass for two. Now how about some defense? Trailing from behind, Cambam gets the steal, and Detch feeds it right back to him for the bucket. Roadrunners cruise 101-86.
I know Cameron Williams missed some free throws. It probably stuck with him all week. Tonight in the second half, he was big for you. Made sure that he came out with a win today. Just talk about his performance.
Well, you know, if you want to be a great player, you have to move past failure at the end of the day. We don't hang on to failure. You know, I hope that he's in that situation again where the game's in his hands with free throws. You know, he'll make them next time.
So the Roadrunners looking to make it to 2 wins in a row, welcoming in Bloomfield College all the way from West Virginia. Bears Dante Julius in transition flies to the rim for the easy layup. Marcus Fleming thinks he's going to get an easy layup, but Bunamakeda stops that notion right then and there with this block. Nick Davidson had some luck in the first half, scoring 12 of his 21 points. Bloomfield carries a 3-point lead into the break, but Enrique Cortes takes over for the red and blue. First, he powers down the slam to start the second half. Cortes then comes up with the steal, he'll get the ball back, and he'll leave the perfect pass for Brian Howard. This time, Cortes takes it himself. The sophomore scored a team-high 20 points to help his team rally for the 79-73 victory.
It feels really good to get these 2 wins here on our home floor. Now we have to start looking forward to the next home games. We have two games next week. We've started the RMAC, and we're really excited about it.
So it looks like our Roadrunners are back on track to make some noise in the NCAA tournament race.
Coach Clark and his squad will begin conference play next month, and you can bet his boys are heading toward that RMAC tournament championship that has eluded them the past 2 years. So what's next on the show, Sean?
Well, I'm so glad you asked, Celeste. We'll bring back our old friend Juan to bring us up to speed on our women's basketball team. Now, if only we could find Juan. Where did he go?
He probably went to go get a sandwich or something. I'll go find him. He does this every show. Sean, tell the audience we'll be right back.
You heard the lady. We're coming right back here on the Roadrunner Review. I hope Juan brings me a sandwich.
Brought to you by your number one volume Nissan dealer, Titans Nissan. Come in today and choose from nearly 1,200 new Nissans. Get 0% for 72 months with no payments for 90 days. During the bottom line event, lease the new Altima for only $149 per month. Gives you both efficiency and performance. Looking for an SUV? Then choose the all-wheel drive Rogue at just $159 per month. Also available with optional third row seat. Bottom line savings at Titans Nissan in Aurora and Fort Collins.
We're back here on the Roadrunner Review, and we found Juan Arellano, who has all the latest on our women's basketball team. Two questions, Juan. First, where did you go? And secondly, did you bring me back anything?
Hey, Sean, I went to find our fearless leader a nice gift from when he returns from the volleyball regionals. What did you get him?
I got him something. Really nice, really fancy. On a totally unrelated matter, though. I have to step out for a minute. It's all yours, Juan. How about that women's basketball team?
Yeah, you gotta do that, Sean. But for head coach Tanya Javi and her squad, they got in some reps before the season actually started as they looked to knock off some off-season rust at home at the Arrera Event Center. On an exhibition match to prepare for the regular season, the MSU Denver women's basketball squad hosted Northern New Mexico College. Emily Harding got things going early on with this jumper, followed immediately with a bucket and the and one. The junior would end the night with 22 points and 8 rebounds. The Roadrunners will show great chemistry as Hardigan finds Ordorf. Ordorf then dishes it to Janae Squires-Horton and she drains a 3-pointer. Demetra Cliche would respond for the Eagles as she drains a 3-point shot to try and stay close with the Roadrunners. The 3-point fest would continue as Jonathan Whitworth is wide open and has time to put up the 3-point shot. MSU Denver with the win over Northern New Mexico 78-53. The following week, MSU Denver opened up the regular season by hosting none other than the defending national champions and the number 11th ranked Lubbock Christian. Hartigan got the Roadrunners on the scoreboard first with his jumper over Bobby Chitsey. Allison Sabo kept the match close for the Lady Chaps with a long-range jumper. Ordorf would take on Sabo with the basket to her back. She shows a great skill on the ball netting the layup. As the Roadrunners' defense opened up, Sabo finds Delaney Gaddis for the easy layup. With the game ticking down, the freshman Bree Willington puts the final nail in the coffin for the home team. MSU Denver with the statement win over Lubbock Christian 67-51.
I feel great. Feel really great for our players and staff. I mean, they've been working so hard. And to have some of their hard work pay off against, like you said, against a really great program. So that's the defending national champion. So yeah, didn't lose a game last year. Didn't lose a game. So. Well, we just want to build on this. You know, there's still some mistakes that we made at the beginning of the second half, lose a little concentration, let them back in the game.
The following night, the MSU Denver Roadrunners would take on Texas A&M Commerce. The Lions came out flying from the first whistle with a layup by Artasia Gay, immediately followed by a shot from downtown by Princess Davis. Jalen Smith would cut to her left, does a spin move to her right, drives it to the lane and gets the ball stolen, recovers it, misses the shot but gets the rebound and ends up scoring for the Roadrunners. In the second half, Ordorf would find Hartigan on the mid-range jumper. She would score 14 points, adding 12 rebounds. With 14 seconds left on the clock, the Lions regained the lead with a layup courtesy of Brianna Wise. The game would go down to the wire, and with 5 seconds left on the clock, Ordorf would miss the bucket. Hartigan recovered the rebound, gets a shot just before the buzzer, but the shot was short. In a nail-biter, Texas A&M Commerce edged MSU Denver 69-68. The Red and Blue played some tough competition in Fairbanks, Alaska and could only muster up one win in 3 games. But they'll look to rebound as they get their conference schedule going in December. And remember, you can watch Roadrunner basketball on Stretch TV at RoadrunnersAthletics.com. I don't see Sean here, so I gotta tell you that we'll be right back with the story of Enrique Cortes and of course the top plays from the past month. I just hope Sean is back in time or it's going to be the Juan Arellano Show very quickly.
I'm standing right here, Juan.
My bad, Celeste. Yeah, so come on back to the Juan Arellano Show. I mean, the Roadrunner Review.
If I lose, I'll respond with respect.
If I win, I'll back it up with humility.
If I fail, I'll rise up with honor. It's tough for us to put it all on the line.
Don't undo my hard work with poor sportsmanship.
Respect. It's the name of the game.
Coming down to the waning moments on the Roadrunner Review, and Celeste Zubia will tell us the tale of sophomore guard Enrique Cortes, who had quite the journey to be here in downtown Denver.
That's right, Sean. It's not unusual to see athletes come from all over the globe to play the sport they love while getting a fantastic education here at MSU Denver. But one in particular is Cortes, who comes across the Atlantic Ocean to play basketball. And here is his story.
MSU Denver es una universidad diversa con estudiantes atletas que vienen de diferentes países para jugar el juego que les apasiona. El jugador de baloncesto Buna Makeda viene de Senegal en África. Dimitri, jugador de fútbol, viene de Francia. Pero estos no son los únicos jugadores que vienen de alrededor del mundo. Enrique Cortes viene de España. Ahí vivía antes de venir a los Estados Unidos.
Tuve una infancia muy buena. Nací en Madrid, que es la capital de España. Y cuando cumplí los 8 años, me mudé a Málaga, que es donde vivo actualmente con mis padres y con mi hermano mayor.
Enrique empezó a jugar fútbol, pero cambió baloncesto cuando tenía 12 años.
Quería cambiar básicamente porque mi hermano empezó jugando al fútbol y yo decidí jugar al fútbol también. Y después mi hermano decidió cambiar al baloncesto y dije, bueno, yo quiero ser como él, así que voy a cambiar y voy a jugar al baloncesto yo también.
En poco tiempo, Enrique se dio cuenta que podía ir más allá de sus talentos.
Yo creo que me di cuenta cuando empecé a jugar para Unicaja, que es el club donde he jugado toda mi vida. Ese club es considerado uno de los 5 mejores en España. Y cuando me di cuenta de que podía jugar para ese equipo, me di cuenta de que podía ser un buen jugador de baloncesto y podría a lo mejor jugar en un alto nivel.
El año pasado trajo sus talentos a MSU Denver cuando empezó su jornada de baloncesto. Pero no fue nada fácil.
Los primeros meses fueron bastante duros, echaba de menos a mi familia, el inglés me costaba mucho.
Enrique se ha adaptado a un nuevo estilo de vida y al juego de baloncesto. Y aunque no sabe si se quiere quedar en los Estados Unidos o regresar a España después de graduación, Enrique está muy agradecido de estar aquí en MSU Denver.
Thanks, Celeste. Now it's time to bring you the top plays from this past month. And as always, they are brought to you by the Regency. Play number 5 comes from the hardwood. And who's this Sunday Dutch kid? He dribbles in, fakes one way, goes the other, and with the one hand, puts in the awkward-looking shot. And give that man the and one as well. Dutch is one name you better keep an eye out for when it's time to hand out that RMAC Player of the Year award later this season. He's going to be fun to watch.
From one great play to one great performance, sophomore Santasia Sturgis came through big when the team needed her in playoff time. The Parker, Colorado native pounded out a career-high 20 kills to help her team defeat Regis in the semifinals of the RMAC tournament. And the Roadrunners needed every last one of them as this one went 5 sets. And by the way, Sturgis also added 10 digs for the double-double. We hope she can continue her great play in the NCAA tournament next month.
More men's hoops in play number 3, and let's watch the versatility of Andre Harris, who flies around the Senators' defense, and he powers down the dunk in front of a home crowd. We need a slower look at that, Mr. Lansing. Who knew Andre Harris could play point guard? He beats 4 defenders to the rack, and look at number 13. He decides to stay away from that poster. So if Cameron Williams or Alec Williams ever gets hurt, Coach Clark knows he can allow the 6'8 big man to run his offense.
It was playoff time for the men's soccer team, and it was time for free soccer as both teams netted a single goal in regulation. Into overtime we go. Nolan Barth lofts in the ball to Josh Belfridge, who turns, nutmegs the defender to Jeff Gillis. Gillis is left unmarked, he fires, and it's in for the game winner. The victory moved the Roadrunners into the semifinals of the RMAC tournament. That was a clutch goal for the senior forward, who also scored the regulation goal as well. Big time player also comes up in big time moments.
The top play is actually the top player in all of the RMAC volleyball world. Our very own Brandi Tor not only won Setter of the Year, but she also took home the Player of the Year as well. The senior from Albuquerque, New Mexico led the RMAC in assists and in assists per set. She reached second place in all-time assists in Roadrunners history, and of course, she was magnificent when it came to defense, both at the net and on the floor. I hope the rest of the NCAA field takes notice. Brandi Tor is coming through with a vengeance to take home that national championship crown.
That is going to do it for this episode of the Roadrunner Review. We hope next month we are back in studio so you can see all of our pretty faces again. And by we, I mean mine.
Wow, really, Sean? Is she saying she's better looking than us? Or is she saying that we're ugly?
I try not to dissect what women are really saying anymore, Juan. I just nod and tell them they're absolutely right. It's a good lesson to remember from when the future Mrs. Ariano comes around, but we'll save the lady talk for another show. For Celeste Zubia, Juan Ariano, and the rest of the Roadrunner Review crew, I'm Sean Tafoya, and we'll see you next time for more high-flying MSU Denver action.